After wasting hundreds of hours cutting metal by hand over the past few years, in this video, I'll show you my top 10 alternatives for cutting steel without an angle grinder. The first tool is a flex shaft rotary tool. Unlike most rotary tools, it has a large external motor that rotates the handpiece. I also have a Dremel but hate using it because the motor bogs down easily and it overheats, so I have to wait for it to cool down between cuts. There are several different cutting discs you can use with major differences. I find that abrasive discs tend to shatter instantly, and if they don't, they last less than a minute, so I end up replacing them more than actually cutting with them. On the other hand, fiberglass reinforced abrasive discs cut much faster, last longer, and are more resilient. Unlike previous ones, diamond discs don't fill the air with abrasive dust, so I use them mostly when cutting indoors. You can also buy different size discs for different cuts, and they don't get smaller as they wear out. There's another huge upside to using these, one I'll utilize later in the video. Hacksaws are the simplest and most versatile tool for cutting metal, a must-have for any workshop, but there's a catch. To cut steel, I use fine-toothed bimetal saw blades. You can even get carbide blades for cutting hardened steel, but those cost more and there are better methods that I'll show next. I use blades with fewer teeth for cutting aluminum since they cut much faster and I can fix the rougher edge they leave very quickly. When cutting thin steel, even the finest hacksaw blades tend to get stuck, which is why I also have a small hacksaw. Small hacksaws use blades that are much thinner and have more teeth, so they cut faster without getting stuck. They are also more practical for cutting through bolts. Their thin blades can fit between even the smallest threads, unlike large hacksaws where you actually have to cut through more metal. I even used my small hacksaw to fix this old bar clamp that kept slipping. If you need to cut several bolts to the same size, don't want to risk damaging the threads in a vise, and want to save time, try this. I find that if you can't tension the blade, cutting accurately without breaking blades constantly is almost impossible. In fact, I hate them so much I converted this broken jigsaw into a handsaw with a quick-release blade clamp, because jigsaw blades are thicker and stiffer. While jigsaws can cut metal, using them for long periods of time is a nightmare. The vibrations make my hand go numb. I find that it's usually easier to start the cut with a hacksaw, since jigsaws often have trouble getting started. Cutting off small pieces can also be challenging because the base plate has to be supported from both sides, but this can help. Despite trying to cut aluminum with an old circular saw that has a horrifically dangerous amount of play in the arbor, it cut through easily. So I got an actual circular saw to do some tests. And it cut through everything I tried cutting, probably 30 times faster than hacksawing, so I thought I'd try brass next. To try cutting steel, I raised the blade to reduce the risk of having the blade snag, though raising it too much can cause the blade to cut slower and get too hot, which I think was the case here. Next up, I quickly improvised a chop saw with a door hinge and a clamp that might look familiar to cut rebar, and my fails, filmed in slow motion, speak for themselves. I expected to cut at least halfway through, but ended up with a broken blade. A while back, I made a video trying to use an angle grinder disc in a circular saw and got dozens of comments telling me I was an idiot, so I knew I had to try it again on this hardened stainless steel tube. But it wouldn't fit, so I made a quick arbor adapter with a washer. Next up is a tool that doesn't only shear metal, it might shear your skin too. Whenever possible, I cut metal with tin snips because shearing is always faster than cutting with a saw. Despite being called bolt cutters, possibly the only thing they can't do is cut bolts without ruining the threads. I wouldn't call these a DIY tool, but they do cut almost everything. I never would have been able to imagine a simple woodworking chisel could cut and carve steel, but it worked. Even with a flimsy workbench like mine that absorbs most of the blow. I often find myself wanting to cut metal, but don't have any tools. One trick I've found is to utilize a feature steel has that engineers hate. If this has helped you, please like the video and consider sharing it with your annoying neighbor that keeps asking to take your tools. I read all comments and respond to as many as I can, so please leave your thoughts below. I'm especially curious if you have any cutting tools you regret buying.